brilliant. Brilliant.
Sam!
I'm not making noise! They are!
Cool it, Sam!
Don't tell me! Tell them, you goat!
Lingo! Shh, listen!
There's the road. All that connects Silver Creek to the outside world is that road and this plane. No crime, no pollution. Knock a hole in the ice and catch a 30-pound char. Of course, for someone from the city...
Oh, no, I'm looking forward to it. The change will do me good.
Miss Lessard?
Jenny.
Jenny, you're in luck. Winter Games start this afternoon. Biggest event in Silver Creek all year.
The Winter Games?
Yeah. You'd be surprised you didn't get.
Man, oh man, if your dad didn't buy those new runners, you're gonna get creamed.
He'll bring them, Jacob.
Off the sled, Sam.
I'm coming with you.
You can ski over. Put on your parka. How many times do I have to tell you to put on your parka?
Yes, Mother. Anything you say, Mother. Damn, kick your butt. He finds out you're leaving me on my own.
Give me it or I'll kick your butt.
Alaskan Huskies. Beauties, aren't they?
And the boys?
Toby and Sam. Since her mother died, they've had to look out for each other a lot.
That must be difficult.
Yeah, the way they look after each other, it ain't easy.
Hike fences!
I like dogs too, but so many?
It's a business, really. I race them all over the province.
And the flying?
It's hard to know what I like better, flying or running dogs.
Bar for
McTeague with the new teacher.
Shoot, I was hoping she'd crash.
What the hell do you kids think you're doing, huh?
Hey.
Isn't this fault?
You know, I think you're just about old enough to be taught a few manners.
Anybody's gonna discipline my kids, it's gonna be me.
Yeah, well, that's just it, Tom. You don't. The kids run wild around here. You must be Miss Lessard. How do you do? I'm Edison Crow. Well, all of us on the school board appreciate your coming in on such short notice. Hope you enjoy your...
Well, it's only temporary, Mr. Crow.
Well, who knows? Maybe you'll get to like it. Actually, Tom, I came down here to discuss some business about Lingo.
I told you she's not for sale.
But I'm willing to go top dollar.
Toby, I believe I'm your new teacher, Jenny Lessard.
I'm Sam.
Hello, Sam.
$5,000 right now.
In time for the race?
No way. It's a fair offer.
Not the way you treat your animals.
Well, you know, I don't think you'll find anyone will offer you that kind of money when the bank moves in on you next month. Your whole shooting match could go for 10, 25 cents on the dollar.
Well, it's a pleasure meeting you, Mr. Sarge. The Silver Creek may not be the most exciting place in the world, but I think this afternoon you might find it a little interesting.
So I've heard.
Really? Well, perhaps I'll see you there. Thomas?
Oh, careful with that one.
It's not true, is it? About the bank?
You've been told about this, haven't you? Running dogs through town. Lingo's got no business running free. What do I have to do to you?
Well, you could kick his butt. Did you get the new runners, Dad?
There won't be any new runners until you kids start wising up.
Where are we going?
I gotta do something with this sled before the race.
Toby!
And next at the starting gate, the Silver Creek Winter Games welcome Wild Bill Johnson and Jimmy Jones. Drivers, get ready. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Okay, right. This is a big one. I want you to dig up those hills. Spark plug, you pull your weight, boy.
Hey, you fellas really look professional.
You look like you're gonna fit right in around here.
Kenny! Glad you could make it. Look, I didn't want you to miss anything, so I saved you place at the starting line.
Good luck.
Yeah.
Team 7 and 8 are on the way. We have a couple of spirited mushers here, folks. One-Eyed Frank still holds the speed record from the Legion Hall to Crow's Nest Bar. Between Edison Crow and Tom McTeague is the one everyone's been waiting for. Either one of these fine teams could easily take next month's provincial championships.
You maybe ain't used to looking at the back of my head, McTeague.
That's all you're gonna see today.
That's what you said last year.
All right!
Yeah! 20 seconds, gentlemen.
Ringo! 20 seconds!
Get wiped.
Oh, yeah? Wait till your pal Mike has to model his underwear.
There he is. Want to say it to his face?
Drive for 5 this afternoon. Meanwhile, Andy Crow has assembled a team of assignments ready to punch the 5. So the big question is, can McPeak dog lingo still make the difference?
I wish I hadn't have made that stupid bet. Then why don't we call it off? I gave my word.
That little shit box will hold together for 5 miles?
Better wear something red tomorrow, Mike. It'll match your face.
What do you mean?
We made a bet.
Loser drives his dog sled into school.
What?
Right into class.
In his underwear.
First thing tomorrow morning.
Look, Mike, this is pretty stupid.
You're not gonna weasel out of this one, McTeague.
Only weasel around here is you!
Go, Lingo,
get
go!
Up, boys, get up! Come on, boys, hey! Hey! Come on, out here! Ah. Ah. Ding! Come on, come on! Go, go, go! Ah. Come on! Ha!
Ha! Go, Lingo!
Come on! Ahead! Atta boy! Run, run! Go! Ding! Ding! Ding!
There is the home stretch now, folks! And Edison Crow is setting a winning time!
That always lets the other guys set the pace.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Come on.
Touch me or my dog with this whip again, I'll use it on you. Sammy!
Will all the junior mushers please get ready for their event? And ladies and gentlemen, there are an awful lot of excited mushers and their dogs here today. If you have a pet animal with you, please keep it tied up at all times.
Class dog event. Are you nowhere?
She's new. Pinhead. Maybe we should have hooked up Moxie and Spook.
No, they're not ready yet.
Hey!
I heard your dogs were ugly. These are really ugly.
And you're a real turkey.
What's the matter with you, Toby? He's psyching you. Now concentrate.
Get yourselves ready.
He might have the speed, but you can nail him on the turns.
Stand aside, everyone.
Toby!
30 seconds till start.
30 seconds, Patches.
How long does it take to check a tow line?
Dad, I did.
Forget it. Accidents happen. Maybe after the provincials, we can look for a new sled for you.
Dad, can I ask you something?
Yeah?
When you give your word on something, should you always keep it?
Sure.
Well, I mean, even if it means trouble for you?
You break your word once, it gets easier to break it again. Pretty soon, it ain't worth much. Neither are you.
What are you gonna do?
Toby, he's off on the vitamins. From now on, they're just for the racers. If I win, we'll all be feasting. I want to talk to you guys. If I don't win the prize money from the provincials this year, we might lose all this. The bank's given me till then.
But, Dad, you always win.
Yeah, Edison Crow has different ideas.
But we got Lingo.
Yeah. I invited Miss Lessard for dinner.
Ugh.
Show her a little northern hospitality, huh?
Lingo, get out.
She's just being friendly.
Hi.
Come on in.
And then Dad won the provincials. And then the Triple Crown. All with Lingo.
When your dad told me he was a racer, I had no idea.
That's enough, Sam.
And that's my mom.
She was very beautiful.
No, she was even more beautiful than that. But Toby didn't get it quite right.
You drew that?
Dinner's ready. Toby, get Lingo out of here.
It's all right, really.
He's a racer, not a house dog.
Toby, do you race her too?
Ah, no, she's Dad's. She just follows me around. Come on.
They don't bite. If they do, we put them down.
Put them down?
Oh, Dad takes them out in the back and shoots them.
There's no other way. I can't afford to feed them. If I sell a mean dog, my reputation's finished.
You wouldn't want a dog, would you?
Toby, she just got here. He tries to sell a dog to everyone he meets.
The trouble is, we have about 10 dogs we shouldn't be feeding. Dad just doesn't have the heart to put them down.
10 beautiful dogs. Smart, good-looking, and can't run worth a shit.
Sam.
Well, that's what you said.
Hmm. This is the best beef bourguignon I've had in a long time.
It's not beef. It's stewed beaver.
Best beaver bourguignon I've had in a long time. So it was an exciting life. A large city is always stimulating. Movies, theaters, music.
Mike Lynn's dad's got a satellite dish. They can get movies 24 hours a day.
I can't understand why he'd want to leave.
Well, for a teacher, new challenges are important. Toby, you really must enjoy drawing.
Well, it is sort of my best subject in school.
His other marks are the pits.
Sam.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Well, there seems to be a few people missing this morning. I guess some students decided to prolong the winter holidays.
I gotta say it, man. You got guts. No brains, but guts.
Get lost, Mike.
Maybe you better go in.
My God. He's not gonna take off his jeans. Oh, no, he's gonna do it.
You're late.
Sorry, Miss Lazard.
Where's Toby?
Oh, he's coming.
When?
Soon.
Jacob, is anything wrong?
Not yet.
Stay in your seats.
Care about them. Patches could be our next lead, Doug. What if you've been hurt real bad?
I'm sorry.
Sure you're sorry. One thing after another with you. You'd been thrown out of school if it wasn't for Jenny.
I didn't have any choice.
Choice?
Oh, forget it. Just forget it. I can't talk to you. If Mom was here...
She's not here.
It wasn't my fault.
No, it's never your fault.
And your bank problem's never your fault either. And now we're gonna lose the dogs.
He's okay. Drive you home.
It was a bet, Tom. He was just trying to keep his word. Be like his macho father.
What are you talking about? He can't go on being a kid all his life.
Oh, you don't whip animals. You whip kids.
I'm gonna build that sled myself. All we have to do is raise enough money for the wood.
How?
We could do odd jobs.
What do you mean, we?
You okay?
Gotta get that money and cream that prick.
As you see, I've written triangle, circle, and square. Now, to draw a circle and a square, I indicate the color, I choose the shape, and move the mouse like this. Now, I've shown you something very simple so you can see how it works, but there are endless possibilities. When I heard that your school board didn't have a budget for computers, I brought along my own.
Far out. Does it have video games?
Sure. With 128K, it's not for video games. But you can make your own games on these discs. But more importantly, you'll be able to put your lessons on it and write your essays. But you, Toby McTeague, of all people, should be paying attention. Your essay from last term had 10 spelling mistakes on one page alone.
And that was on a good day.
Sure doesn't look like your old sled.
Well, I'm trying something new. Less wind resistance, you know, aerodynamic.
Well, I'm very impressed. But not with your spelling. There is no I. The truth is, you're falling behind in almost every subject. I think I can help you, but it'll mean extra work and time.
Well, I don't have a lot of time.
And it sounds like this is closing down. You might have to go someplace else to work when you grow up. So you'd better be prepared.
Hey, how did you do that?
If you can find the time to start working on your spelling and vocabulary, I'm going to show you.
Well, homework. Lots of homework.
You'll survive.
You getting back at him for this morning? Don't worry. I won't tell.
Your name's Sarah, isn't it?
Sarah Donovan.
Let's go, eh?
Could you teach me how to drive a team?
Well, there's nothing to it as long as you know your left from your right.
Will you teach me?
This is your left and this is your right. Let's get out of here.
Come on, man. We're going over to Faulkner's Mill. You want to come with us?
Yeah, I guess.
Hey, where are you going?
I got stuff to do at home.
Jacob!
What's with him?
Hey, Sarah, you want to go for a blast?
Sorry, I've already got plans.
Suit yourself.
I can see you've been trying to please me, trying to be who I want you to be. Speak to me with your heart. See that creek down there?
Yeah.
You want a race?
Would it hurt your ego if I win?
Mysteries we can share if we still care, and I care.
That's the damnedest design I ever saw. Will it fly or what?
I just hope it goes fast.
Fast or not, the wood's gonna run you a good 100.
100? Like in dollars?
Straight grain birch there, eh? That's what you need. You don't want none of that crooked stuff.
Mr. Faulkner, do you sell on credit? When Toby's sled is finished, it'll be worth a lot more than 100, right?
Sure, 300 easy. Maybe more.
So, why don't you give Toby the wood now, so he can get ready in time for the provincial championships?
Yeah, but...
Once he has the wood, he can build the sled. Then if he can't come up with the money by the time the provincials start, you can keep the sled.
She's from the city.
How much did she say she was going to give to you?
What?
Did she say how much she's gonna give you for this job?
In your business!
Come on, stop fooling around. Come on, help your brother. Here.
All right, check it out.
So you can change all the colors I put in. All your different impressions. and then you can have a printout.
Uh-huh.
You can break down each part that you have there, and you can get the precise measurements for all the wood that you're going to be needing.
It's amazing.
Austria.
Vienna.
France.
Paris.
Spain.
Madrid.
England.
London.
Watch this.
By the time we pay for the sled, the snow will be gone.
The way you work, yeah.
Hey, far away, eh? All you that well. Don't put that in here.
Just a minute. Okay, just put them right there. Come on, quickly, quickly.
Three, one, two, three, four. One, two, three. Four.
Sam,
one,
Sam,
two,
Sam.
Three, four,
do you mind?
Come on, double
speed. Double time.
You too. It's been a pleasure.
Love, Mr. Parker.
Yeah, bye-bye. Take care now.
Different, I'll say that.
Think you'll be as fast as that, sled?
There's only one way to find out. Jake?
There wouldn't have been a sled without Sarah.
Right. Come on. Okay, Patches.
Transferred up here to work with Mike's dad at the mine. He's an engineer.
It must have been hard leaving all your friends, huh?
Yeah, a little. But there's lots more to do up here.
Isn't there, Andy? Hey, girl.
Hey, you want some of this?
Believe how fast they go.
Well, Dad's big dogs can average 20 miles an hour in a race.
Do they ever let women race?
You're really getting into this, aren't you?
Thank you.
Come on. Get on. You ready? Put your brake down. Here we go.
Hi!
And remember, G is right and H is left!
Finished your homework? What's that? You really can't do that. You got that from your mom. You know, this sled here, you've really proven that you can set your mind on something and pull it off. I'm proud of you. But you better have those extra assignments finished up by Friday, because I got something else for you to do. Customer wants me to fly him up to Moose Lake. I can't fly anywhere unless I get someone to exercise my dogs. You know, I just need someone to loosen him up for me for the big race on Saturday in Bisbee.
You mean we can run Lingo?
Yeah, all right.
Easy, Rod.
Dad's pulled on.
I know. You're gonna run 16 dogs? 15.
But Dad said to run only 8.
The dogs have to be loosened up, right? That's all I'm gonna do.
Better not, Toby.
I can run 15, no problem. And Lingo here will help me out, won't you?
Toby, this is dumb. You're gonna get in trouble again.
I think you're out of your gourd.
You're just a couple of chickens.
Where are you going? You're acting like a city girl.
You're acting like a jerk who thinks he's really cool. Just like Mike Lynn.
Hey.
Come on, let's get going.
I gotta go home and do some stuff for my mom.
I swear, I don't know what's the matter with everybody today. Come on, Sam, hop on.
No, thanks.
Dad'll never know.
Okay, Mike Lingo!
Lingo,
get ready to hop! Walking!
She was a good dog.
I just whipped her.
That's enough. I just can't trust you anymore, Toby.
You want to come to Bisbee? I better let you come if I ask him.
I love you, Sarah.
Where are you going?
Up to the mountains. Live with the trappers.
Trappers?
Well, you see that mountain? They got cabins up there. I've been there with my dad. Can't stay here anymore. I'll come visit you in the spring, I promise. Like that, we'll make that cabin by lunchtime. Big strike. You have it pulled all morning. Now there's no way the rest of us are gonna carry you along.
We've looked, Jenny.
Edison, you can't give up.
With a big storm coming up, we can't leave the men up in those hills.
No, you're just leaving a boy.
Down. We're gonna have to wait this one out till daylight. Down. Stripe, I knew you'd get hungry.
Hey.
chief's dog. Come here, boy. Wants us to follow.
Run away to the mountains.
He said he couldn't live here anymore.
Search and rescue's been out all afternoon. They've just quit for the night.
The radio says it's going down to 40 below.
What in hell are you doing?
There's nothing I can do until this stops.
Are you going to stay over tonight?
I'll stay until you fall asleep, okay?
Okay.
Trying to finish me off. And don't go telling everyone you saved my skin.
And when she got real sick, I flew her to town. To a specialist. She had chemotherapy. But in the end, there wasn't anything that anybody could do. Toby remembers her well. Him and his mom were real close. I think it's been harder on him. I should have spent more time with him.
Well, it's hard. Flying, training the dogs every day.
I could have made time. I guess championships have just been too important to me.
It's not your fault, Tom. Stop torturing yourself. Why don't you try and get some sleep?
I can't.
So, you're Toby McTeague's boy. What were you doing way up here on your own? Damn foolish. Kid your age. Speak up! Can't believe the spirit sent you all the way from Silver Creek.
Banks got me by the throat. If I don't win the race, I lose the dogs. Seems like everything I touch, I screw up.
Well, you're not the only one.
What do you mean?
Look at me. Andre had no intention of getting a divorce from his wife. I knew it really, but it took a long time for me to admit it to myself. And I ran away up here.
So, you killed a dog and you were running away. Smart. Very smart. I had a boy like that. Chicken noodles, good, good. What are you doing? Didn't your old man ever teach you anything? You feed your dogs first, then you eat. No wonder they bolt on you.
Gone to look for Toby. When you wake up, please maintain a flight watch on VHF 123.45. A flight watch?
Base station 3 Alpha 2X calling Charlie Fox TOM. Base station 3 Alpha 2X calling Charlie Fox TOM.
Roger, 3 Alpha 2X. I'm receiving 080 degrees radial on the Bisbee VOR. I'm grounding 100 knots. Over.
Roger, when do you expect to be over the beacon?
Well, we've always stuck together. Whenever anyone gets into trouble, the rest of us...
Hold on a minute. What makes you so sure the kid even went to Bloody Bear Lake?
The girl. Sarah!
Look, I'm not gonna risk the lives of half the men in this town on the word of some girl from the city.
Only give me those 222s. My head feels like I drank a gallon of moonshine. Grizzly tea. Some people think they have magic power. I'm starved. There's some cereal in one of those boxes.
Did you win all of these?
That's not cereal.
Charlie Fox, T-O-M, calling 3 Alpha 2X.
Roger, Charlie Fox.
I'm gonna try the descent into Bloody Bear Lake now, Sam.
Got it.
But the oil breather pipe's icing up again. I'll have to set her down first try or I'll cook the engine. I got whiteout conditions.
Roger, Charlie Fox, go easy, Dad.
The lake should be coming up soon.
As soon as this thing blows itself out, you're going back. Running away never helped a man yet. My boy found that out.
You hear that?
Just a storm.
No, listen.
Just your imagination. Indians hear things whites never hear.
That's my dad.
Don't be foolish again.
He's got trouble.
And you're going to make it worse. Dogs get mixed up in this kind of weather.
So far, so good.
Asking for trouble flying in this mess. You know that, Jenny.
Edison Crowe, you know that if you were in trouble, Tom would go out after you in a minute.
And until this storm clears, I can't authorize search and rescue.
For the past 70 years, these beaches have been patrolled over weekends and on public holidays by the voluntary lifesavers.
Okay, the storm is over.
Feeling of freedom about, which is one of its joys.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, chunk is stuck there.
Okay, we'll head up across Black's Ridge to the left.
Come here.
Or something back here?
No, it's bolted right down. Oh, easy. So good, Toby.
I'll use the dogs.
No, it's not gonna work, Toby.
Wolf.
Toby, I was so scared. Really scared.
Hey.
I don't ever want anything to happen to you.
I thought about you up there. A lot. I was scared a few times, too.
Hey, this is gross! You're on the bed!
Perfect timing.
Christie's teeth do have some magical power after all.
I believe it.
Jacob, do you believe in magic?
Well,
he's got all these trophies. Was he a racer?
He still holds the speed record between here and Bisbee. He used to deliver mail around here, and he'd go for hundreds of miles by sled.
Taught me more about dogs than anyone I know.
You told me you had a son.
Edward.
I remember.
A long time ago, Edward went away to the city. Quit school. Kind of forgot his friends and family. And then he died there. The old man never got over it. Went off and lived by himself.
So that's why he went kind of sour. He hasn't spoken to a living soul in 10 years.
Guess he kind of blamed white people for what happened.
Good night. See you tomorrow.
Okay, Sam. Bedtime.
Who's coming?
Never mind, bedtime. Evening, Jenny. Tom, how are you coming along? So, you want to talk?
Yeah. I might be interested in selling off the dog operation. If the price is right.
Selling your dogs?
Well, I can't race any more this year anyway.
And the price of feed being what it is.
Dad, you can't! I could run your dogs in the provincials. The
championship isn't for kids.
I might have a chance.
I appreciate what you're trying to do, Toby, but I've made up my mind.
Well, I'd like to help, Tom, but truth is, with Lingo gone, the rest of your dogs just aren't worth that much.
What are you talking about?
Besides, you heard of Panama?
The Alaskan lead dog?
Having her flown in. It's a hell of an investment, but...
Yeah, for a $6,000 prize.
Not planning to stop there. The team I've assembled, I'm looking at the World Championships. Wants to take the provincials. Look, I know you're having bank troubles. What I could do is maybe find something for you down at the hotel. Manager...
I didn't ask you over here to beg for favors.
Just trying to help.
Yeah. Sure.
I just wish you were healthy. Because I'd sure as hell love to beat some of that McTeague pride out of you once and for all. Good night.
Hurry up!
You know what happened last time.
Don't worry, I'll be careful. I'll use the wider trails that I know.
Gotta have that prize money.
And the provincials are only a month away.
Take your mark.
All right, let's get started.
Get set. Go!
Okay, spark plug.
Damn dog. Beecher's afraid of running flat out downhill. She keeps looking back. And Rival's not working for you at all. Shit, he should be a powerhouse.
Rival never takes commands the way he should be.
You want to be serious about racing, you got to get his respect. You got to whip him. He's getting away with murder, Toby, and he knows it. Go on. Double it over so it doesn't cut him. Harder. He's got to learn.
I ever had.
See, you make a big fuss over Rival now.
Good boy, Rival. You really stretched it out.
I admire what you're trying to do, Toby, but I'm afraid it's not going to make much difference.
Well, I'm going to save the dog.
You don't know the first thing about real training.
Then show me.
We're talking 15 miles, Toby. And you can't ride the sled. You got to run and pedal. Trainer's the hardest working dog on the team.
Well, I'm going to try.
You got no control.
I can do it.
Start with 10. We'll work you up. And you got to put Bijou up in double lead. Need some balance up there. Speed and intelligence. Thought you were going to try.
Real good. Now you're going to draw the border between Mexico and the States. That's Baja.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Gonna be all right.
His schoolwork's improved, hasn't it?
Yes. But he's on the point of exhaustion.
No, he wanted to do it. And he just won't quit.
Oh,
going to be smashing up sleds tomorrow if you don't get to bed.
Dad? Do you think I can do it?
Just get the best out of your dogs. The rest will take care of itself.
Good night, Ben.
Good night.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 35th annual Provincial Championship Sled Dog Races. There's an awful lot of excited mushers and their dogs here today.
So please, let's be extra careful.
No flash bulbs near the dogs, please.
Well, with Tom McTeague sidelined and Panama here, who's won three Alaskan championships, things look pretty good for you, Edison.
Well, the way my team's been running, I only wish Tommy was in the race. I just hope the boy doesn't get hurt, that's all.
This is it, rival. Big one.
Hey, Tom, you got a second?
I got all day.
Roll it. Tom McTeague, four-time provincial champ. Now, don't tell me you're planning on racing in the cast.
No. My son Toby's going to be keeping the McTeague name in the roster this year.
There are big changes in the McTeague lineup. We understand you've lost your lead dog, Lingo.
Yeah, I'm afraid that's right.
How's the team without her?
We won't come in last.
We'd better hitch him up. We're running in 15 minutes.
Don't lose this, Toby, or you're out of the race.
I'm proud of you, Toby. No matter what. Give him hell.
Feel like making a little bet? All right, let's go!
Remember, you gotta go 15 miles. So take it easy and come back in one piece.
But if I'm gonna save the dog...
And forget about the money, Toby. What you can do is show Crow and everybody else here that there'll never be a provincial championship without a hard-driving McTeague giving them hell.
I'm racing to win.
You just let them set the pace and keep up with them as long as you can.
Hey, it's the chief with Wolf. What's he doing
here? Well, ladies and gentlemen, with just moments to go before the start of this Battle of the Superstars, we hang on. Hang on. Something strange is happening in the McTeague lineup. There's a last-minute change. They're trying a different lead dog, folks. Something you don't see every day. Now, there's nothing in the rules against it, but not many mushers will take this kind of gamble right before a major race.
Bernie!
wearing them. Well, health is their trouble.
You can't change those dogs, George. He might be pretty, but he's no racer.
He's a pretty good puller, Tom. I trained him myself.
It takes months to train a lead dog.
Dad, I want him.
Drivers ready! In 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Lead, Toby might come in with an 8th or a 9.
Yeah, and he might come in with a broken neck. Save the worst for last. This looks real bad.
It's a
See that patch of ice there? They're gonna have to walk the dogs over that. If they don't.
Here comes Ghost Keeper.
He doesn't see the ice.
See it.
I'm a
my plans are laid and I'm guessing wrong. And I don't belong. I'm just holding on. Come see me fly. Come see the sky. When all said and done, we are. Standing on the quiet edge and you're by my side.